Uber.com. All right, coming up, you got to hear the story from Uber driver to make it league minimum in professional baseball. Yeah. USPBL is the one that made that happen. We'll talk to one of the guys who helped make that happen coming up next here on thefamilydeal.com. 7 Sports Kids. Stay with us. Welcome back to thefamilydeal.com, 7 Sports Cave, joined now by Justin Orenduff, the do-it-all baseball operations general manager, talent finder, talent evaluator, talent fixer over at the USPBL in Utica. Look, we've got the big story from the USPBL. Not only was there a walk-off winner this afternoon over at Jimmy John's Field, but we got a guy playing in Major League Baseball that got his start with you guys. How cool is that?
Oh, it's unbelievable, and it's honestly the pinnacle of what we strive to do at the USPBL, of take these undrafted, overlooked, smaller Division I players, bring them into the league, develop them, hopefully get them signed first, and then for them to reach the major leagues, you know, that's the biggest accomplishment we can have.
Randy Dobnak pitched, what, four scoreless innings?
Four scoreless innings.
Six hits for the Minnesota Twins. This guy was driving an Uber in 2016. Now he's making league minimum playing with the Twins. Now, take me through, like, I know you and I have talked a lot about, like, player development and how cool USPBL is for just another option for players who still want to play professional ball. The money's not necessarily great over there, but it's still keeping that dream that we all kind of have sitting at home going, man, I wish I could play professional sports. Looking at Randy's case, are you surprised that he's playing in the majors now?
This quickly, yes. But I'm not surprised at how consistently he continues to perform. I mean, he was in our league for 7 weeks. He came into our league, had the ability to really pitch. We kind of helped him have a little bit more stuff, increase the feel a little bit, a little sharper breaking stuff. Twins notice, signed him in 17. At every level that he's pitched, he's continued just to brand himself as this consistent performer.
What about that consistent Fu Manchu that he's rocking? That facial hair is something else.
That's new. You know, and that's something that has really carved out a little niche of a fan following and allowed him to really go.
Did you speak with him? Did he reach out to you guys? How has that relationship continued as he's made his way through?
I sent him a message on the night that he found out and we found out. And honestly, like, his dad continues and his family are huge supporters of the USPBL. So, you know, I always follow really his success through his dad's eyes on Facebook.
When you look at the impact, I mean, what's that clubhouse like now with all these other guys? You have four teams over there. They're all seeing Randy go out and pitch basically a gem out there. They're probably like, what do I got to do to get that opportunity? Is that kind of the buzz over there?
It changes the entire scope of, you know, as a staff, what we do, how we can kind of communicate, market to future players of the USPBL. And for this season, you know, this week we also had two players, our 33rd and 34th players, signed with the Rockies. So we're having a lot of success on the field, and these players that are currently in the USPBL, you know, there's a good energy going around to say, whoa, this is actually a gateway to where I can actually get to the major leagues.
I know you're well connected with major league personnel, if you will. These signings can only keep more guys calling you guys, knocking on the door, sending scouts. Have you guys seen an uptick in attendance by scouts and people asking for tape of different guys, or because of not just Randy, but over the past couple of years, 34 players now signed by major league teams?
Absolutely. And so, you know, one thing that I do weekly is create this email list of all the statistics and analytics on our guys, include some video, and we've had more organizations jump on board that list. And so we don't necessarily have to have scouts at the game, because we can kind of send them the info now so they can get a pulse of who's in the league. And every player that gets signed that has success, the next guy, and they're going to be more, you know, leaning to come to our league.
We're not done. This isn't the last guy we'll see pitching in or playing in the majors for USPBL, right?
I don't think so. I think there will be quite a few more in the next few years.
Now that's a hot take, but coming up next, Justin, thank you so much for being here.
Justin,
always appreciate it. You got to hear a hot take from a 12-year-old, the youngest hot take we've ever had here on thefamilydeal.com.